Now, in this class, we'll find the magnetic field intensity due to a circular wire by applying the same Biot-Savart's law. So, in order to find the magnetic field intensity due to circular wire, I need to take the circular wire, right? So, I am considering the circular wire for simplicity. Along xy plane, circular current carrying wire is considered along xy plane. So we generally consider this as x axis, this as y axis, and this is the z axis. So I am considering the circular wire carrying a current of I in xy plane like this. So this looks almost circular, not exactly circular, please adjust. Okay, so this is a circular wire which I am considering, which is along xy plane. I cannot draw a three-dimensional figure in a two-dimensional plane. This is an xy plane. In xy plane exactly, I have the current carrying wire which is carrying a current of I. Okay. And I am interested to find the field intensity due to this circular wire along the axis of the circular wire at a particular height. Okay. So this is the point of interest P. So here P is nothing but the point of interest. Point of interest is nothing but the point where we want to find the field intensity. Okay. So I am considering the point of interest along the axis of this circular wire, because if the circular wire is in xy plane, the axis of the circular wire is z axis. I am considering the point of interest on z axis, okay, at a particular height. So let us assume this height of the point of interest from the center of the circular wire, this is the center of the circular wire or origin. So this is the height I am considering. Now what are the coordinates of this point? So x coordinate is 0, y coordinate is 0 because the point is in z axis. And what is z coordinate? It is h, right? So I am interested to find the field intensity at this point due to this current carrying wire which is placed in xy plane with its center as the origin, right? And let us assume that the radius of this circular wire as rho, the circular wire radius is rho, okay. So rho is nothing but radius of circular current carrying wire or circular current carrying conductor, okay. Now, how can I find the field intensity? So according to Biot-Savart's law, what is the expression for field intensity? It is dH bar is equal to I dl bar cross r bar by 4 pi r cube. This we have studied in the previous class. Is it right or not? According to Biot-Savart's law. Now what is this? This is the differential field intensity due to the small circular element, right? So let us consider the small circular element here. Let us consider the small circular element here. So in this entire circular wire, I am considering a small circular element, and I need to join this element with the point of interest. What is this? This vector will be r bar. So r bar is always a vector which is drawn from the element, current element, and the point of interest. Now how can I select dl bar for this current element? When you are considering a circular system or a cylindrical system, you need to consider dl bar as, see here, from here to here, if you observe, there is only variation in phi. There is no variation in rho. When you move from this point, for example, I am just considering here, between these two points, if you move, what is the only variation you can observe? the only variation which we can observe is the variation in phi, because at this point rho is same and at this point the rho is same. When you move along a circle, the radius remains constant or rho remains constant, as well as z also remains constant. What is z value? As the circular wire is in xy plane, at each and every point on this circular wire, z value is always 0 and rho is constant. Rho and z are constants, hence you don't have d rho and dz. Actually, in cylindrical coordinate system, what is dl bar? It is d rho a rho bar plus rho d phi a phi bar plus dz a z bar in cylindrical coordinate system, right? As there is no variation in rho we are observing along this circular wire, and as there is no variation in z we are observing, d rho and dz both becomes 0, and you left with dl bar as only rho d phi a phi bar. Now in place of dl bar, what I can write? Rho d phi a phi bar, rho d phi a phi bar. And how can you get r bar from these vectors? If you, I want to redraw here, this is the one vector which is having the magnitude as h and the direction along positive z. If you consider along positive z direction, you will get plus a z bar. If you are considering along negative z direction, you will get negative a z bar, and the magnitude is h. And what about this vector? This vector has a magnitude of rho, and what is the direction? A rho bar. Now this is another vector. What is this vector? This is r vector, r bar vector, right? Now if I want to get this vector, I need to add this vector in positive z direction, and I need to take reverse for this. If it is rho a rho bar, positive radial direction away from the center, when you are moving towards the center, you need to consider this as minus rho a rho bar. Now if I consider like this, now the summation of these two vectors is this vector. Now what is this vector? This vector has the magnitude of rho and the direction is negative radial direction, so minus a rho bar. And this vector has the magnitude of h and the direction is along positive z direction, so h a z bar. Now what is the r bar? It is the summation of these two vectors, okay? So it is minus a rho bar, rho a rho bar plus h a z bar. This is r bar value, r bar vector value, and this is dl bar. Now if r bar is this value, what is the magnitude of r bar? The magnitude of r bar is nothing but r, and it is given by root of rho square plus z square, root of rho square plus z square. Now let me find dh bar. Before finding dh bar, I need to know dl bar cross r bar value. This is dl bar and this is r bar, so find dl bar cross r bar. Dl bar cross r bar is equal to rho d phi a phi bar cross minus rho a rho bar plus h a z bar. Now taking the cross product between different unit vectors, you need to follow the right handed system, conventional system. So a rho bar a phi bar a z bar. When you are taking a rho cross a phi, you must get a z bar. When you are getting a phi bar cross a z, you must get a rho, and a z bar cross a rho bar is a phi bar. When you are moving in clockwise direction, you will get plus. When you are moving in anti-clockwise direction like this, you must get negative, okay? Now a phi bar cross a rho bar, a phi bar cross a rho bar, anti-clockwise direction. So a phi bar cross a rho bar is minus a z bar. So minus minus plus, so that you will get rho square, rho into rho square d phi AZ bar. Similarly, A5 bar cross AZ bar. So A5 bar cross AZ bar is arrow bar, because we are moving in clockwise direction plus arrow bar. So that you will get rho H D5 into arrow bar. So this is the DL bar cross R bar value. Now if you observe, this gives us the direction of the field. DH bar direction now is simply in two directions. One is, this is the component DHZ, which is along Z axis, right? So DHZ AZ bar plus, this is the component along rho, so DH rho arrow bar. So the field is in Z as well as the radial direction. The resultant field is in Z as well as radial direction. Okay. Now, if you clearly observe, because of the availability of symmetry here, because of the availability of symmetry, so actually how is the field? It is in Z and rho direction. Z and rho direction means like this. And here also it will be in Z and rho direction. So when you consider an element here, you can also have one more element exactly opposite to this element, exactly at an angle of 180 degrees and with the same radius from the center, same distance from the center, you can have one more element here. Because of that element, you have the field in this direction. Okay. So, if you take the resultant of these two vectors, this vector has horizontal component as the radial component and vertical component as the Z component. And this also has the horizontal component as the radial component and the vertical component as the Z component. If you observe here, all the horizontal components or the radial components are getting cancelled and Z components are only getting added. Z components are only getting added up because of the symmetry. So what we can understand here, what is the symmetry we have here? Because of the radial symmetry. Why it is radial symmetry? Because you have, if you consider one element, you will have one more element exactly opposite to that element, radially opposite to that element. Okay, so this this element, due to this element, the field is in positive Z direction and radial direction. Because of this element, the field is in positive Z direction and radially opposite direction. So that the radial components are getting cancelled due to each and every element. Because when you consider the element here, you will have one more element exactly opposite to this element. Because of this element, you have again the radial components getting cancelled and the Z component getting added. So because of radial symmetry, all the components, all the rho components of field will get cancelled. All the rho components of field will be cancelled. If all the rho components are cancelled, the resultant field will be in Z direction. Okay. The resultant field will be in, if all the radial components are getting cancelled, the resultant field will be in Z direction. Okay. So I can make this component as zero. You will have only this component which left. So what is the value of this component? It is a rho square d5 AZ bar. Okay, now let me rewrite the equation for differential field intensity, which is a dh bar. So dh bar is equal to I, you will get as it is, dl bar cross r bar, and this is the component, you will get as it is, I rho square d5 AZ bar, I rho square d5 a z bar divided with 4 pi r cube. So r cube means rho square plus z square. Here it is 1 by 2. If you take cube, you will get 3 by 2. Rho square plus z square whole power 3 by 2 ampere per meter. Okay? This is dH bar. Now, what is z value? Where we are finding the magnetic field intensity? We are finding the magnetic field intensity at this point where the z is h. Z value is equal to h, right? Find the field intensity, total field intensity. Taking the integration on both sides, you will get here integration of I rho square d phi divided with 4 pi into rho square plus h square whole power 3 by 2, rho square plus h square whole power 3 by 2 a z bar ampere per meter. Okay, now for this integration, what are the constants? I rho square 4 pi into rho square plus h square 3 by 2, everything is constant. You are left with only d phi. Now I can write it as I rho square by 4 pi into rho square plus h square whole power 3 by 2 integration of d phi. What is the direction of the field? Ampere per meter. So direction of the field is along positive z direction. So integration of d phi is phi within the limits of 0 to 2 pi, so that this entire integration value becomes equal to 2 pi. So it is I rho square into 2 pi divided with 4 pi into rho square plus h square whole power 3 by 2 a z bar. You can find this fact, which is the field along z axis, not only by the concept of symmetry but also by applying right hand thumb rule. See here, if the field is like this in phi direction, sorry, if the current is in phi direction, this is the circular wire which is considered along xy plane, considered in xy plane, carrying a current of I. So because of this direction of current, how will be the field? According to right hand thumb rule, you can understand that the field will be like this. Is it right or not? The field will be like this. Because of the current direction, you can understand that the field is like this. By applying right hand thumb rule also, you can understand that. Now if you observe what is the resultant direction, you can see it is along positive z direction, vertically upwards, the resultant field direction. That's why we got the field along positive z direction. So this is the magnetic field intensity h bar at a point along the axis of the circular wire, which is at a height of h. So h bar at a height h along the axis of this circular wire is equal to I rho square by 2 into rho square plus h square whole power 3 by 2 a phi bar ampere per meter. This is the expression which will be helpful to find the field intensity. Let me write here. So you need to understand this one, where we can use this mathematical expression or equation to solve the numerical problem. Okay, it gives us the field intensity, it gives us the magnetic field intensity at a point along the, or at a height, or at a point along the axis of circular wire, along the axis of circular wire, okay? If this is the circular wire, if you want to find the field along its axis at a particular height h, it may be above this circular wire or below this circular wire, the value remains same. Okay, then you can use this formula. If the circular wire is of radius rho and the point along the axis is at the height of h, by substituting h and rho values here and the current through this circular wire, you can get the field intensity. Now let us see the special case. So in the examination, the special case is if the point is exactly at the center. Special case is if the point of interest P, what is P here? The point of interest where we want to find the field intensity. If the point of interest P is exactly at the center of the circular wire, okay, if point P is at the center of circular wire, means what is the meaning for this? You have a circular current carrying wire and you want to find the field intensity at the center of the circular wire. So what its value becomes? If we are considering the P exactly at the center of the circular wire, H becomes 0. We are bringing this point to here. So the height becomes 0. Now by substituting H value 0, you will get exactly the field intensity at the center of the circular wire, 0, 0, 0. It is equal to I into rho square divided with 2 into, if you substitute h 0 here, you will get rho square only. Rho square whole power 3 by 2 is rho cube. So I by 2 rho cube a phi bar. So rho square gets cancelled. Okay. So now, this is a h bar exactly at the center. This is the field, magnetic field intensity exactly at the center of a circular wire. I by 2 times the radius. A phi bar, what is the unit? Ampere per meter. So in the examination, if it is asked us to find the field intensity at the center of a circular current carrying wire, you can do up to here and by substituting H value here, you will get the answer. Okay. In this way, you need to attempt the question in your examination. They may ask or they may not ask. They may ask to find the field intensity at the axis of a circular wire. Then you can stop up to here. If it is asked to find the field intensity exactly at the center, then in this expression, you need to substitute H value as 0. Okay. Is it clear up to now?